Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video we will learn how to create or set up AWS code pipeline so it will automate your software delivery process using continuous integration and delivery pipelines. It means we don't need to redeploy code again and again. So in this video what we will do, first we will create one Spring Boot project and then we will deploy or push this code to GitHub repository. Then AWS code build will take or check out the code from GitHub repo and then create the build for this code, and after successful build it will deploy this code into Elastic Beanstalk. So in the future if there is any requirement to change the code in project, then we just need to push the code into GitHub repository only. Then it will build the code by using AWS code build and it will automatically deploy into Elastic Beanstalk, and everything will be taken care by AWS code pipeline. So now we know as AWS code build will take care of create the build of the project. But AWS code build do not know how to build the code. For this, we need to create a YML file, and this file named will be as buildspec.yml. And in this file, we need to configure the steps how to build the code. So AWS code build will take this file as input file, and then will build your code. And when the once code build is successful, then we will deploy, then it will automatically deploy into Elastic Beanstalk. And this entire process will take care by AWS code pipeline. So okay, let's start it. So first we will create one Spring Boot project, and here I have already created one Spring Boot project, and in this Spring Boot project I have created one controller class, that is message controller, and inside message controller I have created one REST endpoint, that is get message, and mapping type is get. So here I am just returning one string value, that is AWS code pipeline deployment. And inside pom.xml I have just added one dependency, that is Spring Boot starter web. So here I have just added one dependency, that is Spring Boot starter web. And here I have created one file that is related to AWS code build. So AWS code build will take the buildspec.yml file as input file. So in this file we need to configure the steps how to build the code. So here we have defined version, that is 0.2, and faces build commands. So when the build will start, this message will be printed on console, echo enter the build phase, and then we will perform maven clean package. And after the successful build created, then this message will be printed on console, build completed successfully. And artifacts files, here we have defined the jar file location, and our jar file name is messaging.jar. And here we have defined final name as messaging. So once when the jar will be created, its name will be messaging.jar. And after creating this project, we need to push the code into GitHub repository. And I have already pushed this code into GitHub repository. And my repository name is messaging repo and branch is master. So here we have already created buildspec.yml file that will be used by AWS code build. And after successful build, the code will be deployed into Elastic Beanstalk. So first we need to create one Elastic Beanstalk instance. So first I will go to browser and here I will open Amazon console. And here first we need to create Elastic Beanstalk. And here we need to configure application.properties file, And inside application.properties file, we need to define server port as 5000 that will be used by Elastic Beanstalk. Okay, now next we need to create Elastic Beanstalk. Elastic Beanstalk environment. So click on Elastic Beanstalk. So now we need to click on environments. And here we need to click on application, create application. And here we just need to provide the name for application name. So here I will give messaging service. Messaging service as application name. And next thing, we need to define the platform. So here I will select Java. And platform branch will be Java 8. And next we need to select platform version. And here we need to select sample application and click on create application. So this process will take a few minutes to create the environment. So here we can see messaging service environment has been created successfully and its health is showing green. So we can go to their environments and check here messaging service environment has created. Now what we need to do next thing. Now we need to configure AWS code build after creating Elastic Bean instance. So here we will go to browser and open one more console. So here we will open AWS Amazon console. Log back in. Now we need to configure AWS code build and we need to tell AWS code build that this is my GitHub repo and take the checkout of the code from this and build it and create jar for it and then deploy to Elastic Beanstalk. So what we will do here, we will select code pipeline. So click on code pipeline. And here we need to click on create pipeline. Here we define messaging service pipeline. Messaging service pipeline. And no need to define service role. It will be automatically populated based on our pipeline name. And next, what we need to do, click on next. Now next thing is source provider from where we want to check out the code for it will be GitHub repository. So here we will select GitHub repo and now we need to connect to GitHub. So here we need to define connection name messaging service connection. Now click on connect to GitHub. Now here we will select our GitHub credential and click on connect. Then it will show successfully connected to GitHub. Now we need to select repository name where our code is placed. So here messaging repo is the GitHub repo. And we can see the name of our repository from here, messaging repo, and branch is master. Next, we need to select the branch that is master and use code pipeline default. Click on next. And next, we need to add build stage information. Here, we need to select build provider. So, this build provider will be used to build our code. So, here I have selected AWS code build and region is Asia specific. And now we need to select project name. So, here we will click on create project. If we have not created already, then by click new project and here we need to assign project name that is messaging service project. Description is optional and next we need to add managed image or custom image. So here I will use environment image as managed image. So here we need to select operating system, that is Amazon Linux 2, and runtime will be standard, and image here we will use latest version, that is 3.0. And the next one is role name will be automatically populated, and use a build specific file, or we want to insert build commands. If you want to enter manually build commands, then we can select this option. Otherwise, if we have mentioned build spec file in our project, then we will select this option. And as we know, we have already created build spec file in our project, so we will choose this option. And next we will click on continue to code pipeline. So successfully created messaging service project to code build. And after creating the project, now we return to the same screen, and here what we need to do, click on next. And after completing these three steps, choose pipeline settings, add source stage as GitHub we have added, and build stage we have already added. Now we need to add deploy stage. So here I will choose AWS Elastic Bean for deployment. As we know, we are using Elastic Beanstalk for deployment. And here we need to define application name, that is messaging service. And next thing, we need to select environment name, that is messaging service environment. Now next. So here we can review all steps we have completed. Pipeline settings, that is messaging service pipeline we have created, and we have added source stage as GitHub. And the next, we have created build action provided, and here we are using AWS code build to build the code. And next thing is deploy action provider, and here we are using AWS Elastic Beanstalk. Now just click on create pipeline. So it will take time to create and establish the pipeline. So first thing is source in progress. After source, it will build the code by using AWS code build. So here we can see source is succeeded, and the next is build. So AWS code build is in progress. So it will make the build by using buildspec.yml file. And after successful build, it will deploy the code into Elastic Beanstalk. So here we can see our code build is succeeded by using AWS code build, and the next thing is deploy in progress. And here we can also see the latest commit message. So here deployment is also succeeded. Now we will go to our AWS Elastic Beanstalk, and here we can see messaging service environment. And if we want to get this environment, we just need to click on this URL so we can access it. So here we just need to provide our endpoint specific URL, that is message. So here we can see the response, that is AWS code pipeline deployment. That message we are returning from our REST endpoint. So next, what we need to check, if there is any requirement to do some code changes in our project, then what we will do, here I will go and just change the return message redeployment. So save it. And now what I will do, here I will go to my repository and just commit my code and push to GitHub repo and updated response message and just click on commit and push to our GitHub repo. The thing there we need to do, only just need to push code into GitHub repo, and other thing will be take care by AWS code pipeline, how to build the code. and how it will deploy. Everything will be taken care by AWS code pipeline. So we just need to push code into GitHub repo, that we have done. So close this. Now I will go to my code pipeline. So here I will refresh it. And here we can see our code build is in progress. So it again making the build. And here we can see latest commit message, updated response message, that we have just committed the code and added this message. So it will again take time to make it build. But here we can see it is a previous message, but this one is the latest message. So once that process will come into in progress, then there will be updated. Updated response message. The response message first was AWS code pipeline deployment, but now we have updated and make it as redeployment. So after successful deployment, we will check it again. And now our AWS code build is succeeded. And now in deploy, we can see the latest and updated message, that is latest commit message. So here now we can see deployment process is also succeeded. Now we will go to our browser and refresh this endpoint URL. And here we can see updated message that we did changes. AWS code pipeline redeployment. So it was all about CI/CD pipeline, that is AWS code pipeline. And okay, thanks for watching this video.